I should be entitled to half those reward points. I eat more than you.
I've noticed. Hurry up. I've got frozen food in there, it'll thaw.
Well, you carry it then.
I can't. This chair's calibrated to my weight. A few ounces out and it'll break down.
I don't know what you did before you had me for a slave. I do your shopping. I carry your shopping. I was going to ask G to get you a dishwasher before I realised he's got one. Me.
Ticks.
No. Come on, we'll go back.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Hey, you blocked us in, mate.
Set the alarm off. That'll bring him back. It's no good. It's not working. Put the window through.
Oh, come on. He didn't hear me.
So I wait politely till he gets back. He might be gone for months. I'll starve.
Well, you won't. We've got supplies.
The frozen food. You need to get it home. It'll thaw.
I don't care. I'm waiting here with you.
I care.
It cost a fortune.
All right, look, I'm 10 minutes tops, all right? Stay there.
I feel like I'm wasting your time.
Don't be silly. Your car's been vandalised, you've a right to expect action.
There's just nowhere safe to park around here.
Well, what about that space at the front?
It's a disabled spot.
Well, none of the residents drive, so it won't matter.
It's a disabled parking space. We don't abuse disabled parking spaces at Bramble Lodge.
OK. Well, we all know which lad's damaged a car, and I think it's time to look at antisocial behaviour orders.
Oh, but they're only kids.
Kids who've made this area impossible to live in. I want you to start keeping a log. I want times, dates.
I got here as quickly as I could. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Right, sit down. Sarah, make her a cup of tea. We're going to hunt these bastards down, Jean. They make me want to vomit. Physically vomit.
They're only teenagers.
You can't know that.
I can. I saw them do it.
I've got a few ideas of my own who's responsible. You leave this one to me. Oh! Sorry. Are you in a hurry?
I am, yeah.
Don't you want to know why I'm here?
To hang around Jean on the pretense that it's police business?
To investigate a series of vehicle crimes in the area.
Yeah, about time you did something about that. Jean's just been broken into again.
Oh!
What?
Whoever mentioned Jean? I never mentioned Jean.
No, I did. He's just had a car broken into again.
I never mentioned Jean's car. You've just mentioned Jean's car.
Oh, bog off.
What's in the bag, Sheldon?
Oh, you've got me. There's some knock-off radios and some furry dice.
Really?
Yeah, and some smack.
Right, well, in that case, you better come with me.
What?
Oh!
Fish fingers. Oh, pancakes. Findus crispy. Ice cream Mars bars. Look, are you getting all this?
Too right. If these match the items taken from Jean's car, then the only bars you're going to be seeing...
Look, why would I...
Let me finish. A prison bars.
Me and Jean are friends. Pretty close friends, as it happens. Why would I touch a car?
Cry for help. Chemical imbalance in the brain. Maybe your mammy never hugged you as a child.
Can you at least turn the lamp off? You're defrosting my onion rings.
The only onion rings where you're going.
Yes, what?
Prison onion rings.
Oh, look, it was kids what done it, Jean's car. She caught it on CCTV.
CCTV. It's very convenient.
Yeah, it is very convenient. That's what it's for.
Jean's given me the names of these lads, Sarge. No surprises.
Well, you've got away with it this time. I am watching you. Alright?
Oi!
You took your time.
Don't even go there, Paul. I have just been harassed by Julian Bravo.
Big deal. I was falsely imprisoned.
So what happened? One of the drivers come back?
No, Sheldon, I'm still there.
Well, did you have a pop at them?
It was a little old lady. She was nervous enough anyway. So, yeah, had a go at her.
Oh, that's not very nice, is it?
It's no excuse being old. Drivers should be more considerate. Look at this. Our one and only disabled parking space. It's not even our car.
How do you know?
None of us can afford one.
Well, it shouldn't really bother you then.
It's the principle, Sheldon. If people don't defend their principles, You get anarchy. That's how Hitler got in.
Yeah, but he only had one ball, Paul. He might have been entitled to park there.
It's nice to know you care.
I do care. Crispy pancake?
We'll see who's entitled.
Crossbred hunting dog, Festa or Lurcher?
Lurcher.
Look at you lot. Not even bothered that our rights are being infringed out there.
Mary Poppins.
Another car's parked in our spot.
Who cares? We don't use it.
Oh. So that gives them the right, does it? Today,
the sun.
They've taken our parking space. But tomorrow they could take our...
bagpipes.
Our civil rights, Dorothy.
Well, Malcolm X, what are you going to do about it?
Use
I'm
going to
wait for the driver and give him a piece of my...
Grumpet.
Graham, are you even watching that?
I wouldn't worry about it, Paul. I've got a plan for me. I'm going to get myself some wheels.
Well, that'd work.
War.
One of us uses it.
Yeah, well, that's me always thinking. I'm going to go and keep an eye out for that driver and tell him the bad news.
Pyramid.
You see that? That's what we can do when we work together.
Didn't think Sid had enough money for his dinner, never mind a car. Where's he getting the money from?
4 hours you've been parked there.
Yes, and we said £2 an hour, is that right?
Yes, that's £8, please.
Tell you what, keep the change. Might as well, since it's going to charity.
Very generous of you. The charity will be grateful.
Oh, it's worth it. Such a rough area, this. This is the only spot where you know your car's safe.
Tell me about it. Country's going right down the toilet. Same time again tomorrow?
Yeah.
Drive carefully.
They've all melted. It's useless.
I told you, I've been a victim of police harassment.
Stop moaning. Where's my ice cream Mars bars?
PC Plug took them.
That's police harassment. What happened? Did you catch the driver?
For what it's worth. I mean, she just laughed at me, threw a squash racket in the back of the car and drove off. Still, never mind, eh? Tried my best.
Right. Next time it happens, we'll set Sheldon on them.
Super Swithenback would love that, wouldn't he?
Right. We'll just watch and take times and registration numbers and hand the information to the police.
Yeah, and demand they take action. Good idea, Paul. The police think they can harass me, I'll harass them back.
Exactly.
No, you can't.
Why not?
Well, I mean... No, you can't do it on your own. No, we'll do shifts. I mean, I can do mornings between 9:30 and 11:00, and I can do afternoons, you know, 3 till 6.
We don't need a rota, do we? We just take turns, keep an eye out.
We're having a rota.
Fine, we're having a rota.
Great, man. Here we go.
Well,
back
about now, mate.
Yeah, try not to be too late, will you, because there is someone else due.
All right. All right.
It's 2 hours, wasn't it, yeah?
Yeah, it was.
Not going, is it?
Wait. Just visualise the handbrake being off. Yeah. No good.
I spy with my little eye.
My turn.
Yeah. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you for that.
Thank you.
Please come again, Mark.
Thank you.
And let that be a lesson to you! There goes another one, look, eh?
Bastard!
Funny how you're always seen when the drivers turn up, isn't it, Sid?
Yeah, I know, I'm getting hoarse shouting at them.
Do you want to swap shifts?
No.
Doesn't matter. Got enough evidence with the police now.
Well, do we have to really involve the law? I mean, you know, I'm getting to like this vigilante stuff. We could get some red berries.
What, you mean like strawberries?
Raspberries.
Oh, blueberries.
Well, not because they're blue, aren't they?
Oh, look, come on, grow up. I meant apps. That way, we could take the law into our own hands.
No, Sid, we're going to tell the police. This is a criminal matter.
I'd love to help you, but I'd need more evidence.
You didn't need more evidence when you accused me of vandalising Jean's car.
I'd keep quiet if I were you. That investigation's ongoing.
We have got some evidence, actually, Sergeant. I've brought you a dossier.
I think you'll find it's pronounced Dosser.
Not him. This. Times, dates, licence numbers, make, model and colour... plus any distinguishing features. I've also recorded descriptions of the drivers where possible, some of them cross-referenced with photographs.
Yeah, it's not much to go on, is it?
What do you mean? Go and stand outside that place for 10 minutes, you'd catch someone.
I can't waste time hanging around.
You're always hanging around that place.
Have you got a problem with that, huh? Something going on you don't want me to see, is there? Besides, it's not a police matter.
You want to take that to the council?
You could clamp them.
I could clamp you. Go on, hop it.
Swithenback's an idiot. What's worse is he gets paid out the tax I'd pay if I paid tax.
You're right, Shelp. The law is an arse. Time for direct action.
What do you mean?
Why do people park in our disabled spot? Because it's safe. Even the scallies don't touch it. It's like a sacred parking spot.
I suppose, but...
if cars got vandalised there too, it'd lose its value.
Yeah, but how do we make them get vandalised? Oh, Paul, you're not going to do it, are you?
Don't be silly. Of course I'm not going to do it. One good scratch down the side.
I'm not sure about this, Paul.
Come on, it'll only take a second.
What are you doing?
Reclaiming the streets. Should have done this a long time ago.
Well, hang on. Isn't that a bit drastic?
We've been driven to it.
He's right, Sid. We've got to do something.
Well, what about just doing the tyres?
Yeah, that seems like a fair compromise.
I meant with the valve.
Gotcha.
That's enough. Yeah, that'll teach him.
That's barely a fart's worth. At least do it properly, Sheldon.
I'm going out, me. I'm going out of me.
Yeah.
Hey,
fellas. I need your help. There's a tramp round there vandalising my car.
What does it look like?
Oh, great big thing, you know, long coat, greasy hair.
Meant your car.
Oh, right. It's a Vauxhall, I think. I'm parked in the disabled bay at Bramble Lodge there. It's my lifeline to the outside world, that car. I mean, how else am I going to get for my medicine? Or see my grandkids, who are also disabled.
Afternoon.
You're scum, you are.
What?
Attacking an handicap car.
Ah, go and play with the traffic.
Are you going to stop?
No. You're a lot of vandals anyway.
Not on disabled cars. We've brought up proper.
Look, it's not a disabled car. Tell him.
Do you know this guy?
No. Assumed he was from QuickFit.
Paul?
My name's not Paul.
Right.
Thanks for speaking up for me there, Paul.
They wouldn't have listened.
I might.
You didn't need my help. They're only kids.
Yeah, four of them. The worst thing is about kids, you can't properly deck them.
Yeah. Notice that.
Bloody hoodies, the one locking up.
That's the reason I didn't stop them, Shell. You were right underneath the CCTV. Police are here now checking the tape for the Asbos. Ow!
You keep watching it over and over again, Sergeant. Is there a particular clue you're looking for?
No, I just like it.
Oh, Sheldon, love, are you all right?
No, I'm not actually, Jean. I could do with a bit of a rub down, you know, some essential oils.
Or... he's fine. We've nicked those kids yet?
We've identified them. I can't see a problem getting Asbos after this.
Don't be so sure of that.
What do you mean? This is evidence, surely?
Yeah, but evidence of what?
Yobbish behaviour or... concern young men trying to stop a vandal.
Oh, bollocks.
I've been onto you from the start, trying to blame kids for your own hooliganism. Look at this, Jean. You've had a viper in your buxom. Bosom! A viper in your bosom.
Sheldon, is that you?
Well, it's not CGI.
All right. I let the tyres down on one car.
That's a confession.
It was illegally parked.
You all heard that.
I only did it because you're so lazy. I'm being victimised.
Not yet, you aren't. Oh. I'm going to take you for a ride in my car. And if you damage this one, I'll damage you.
Did you hear that? That was a threat. Did you hear?
See that? These lads were so disgusted with your actions, they're fixing the tyres themselves. Good on you, boys.
Well done, lads.
Thanks.
Little sods.
Cheers, lads.
It's all done for you, that, mate.
Where did you get the pump?
Oh, I nicked it. Make sure you look after yourself.
Yeah. Thanks again, lads.
Oh, hello there. I made that 2 hours, you know. Topped your tyres up for you. Oh,
nice. Should we call it a fiver?
Sheldon's not a vandal, you know that.
Paul, I've seen the evidence. And I've been a victim of car crime myself.
Sheldon was sticking up for us, and now you've abandoned him.
You're a hard woman, Jean. I always thought you saw the good in people.
Oh, don't start that.
Just when he was putting his life back together, you've kicked him aside like a donkey.
Not a donkey, no. More a naughty fox or a...
Jean!
All right! I'll phone the police station and have a word. Is that good enough for you?
I only hope we're not too late.
I can manage this without your supervision, thank you.
Police station, how can I help?
PC Madden, please.
Can I help you?
Councillor Stafford. We met at last month's meeting.
Oh, yes. Hello.
Just come to have a look round. Make sure everything's running smoothly.
Right. Is it some sort of surprise inspection?
Oh, no, nothing like that. We just didn't tell you about it. Have I chosen a bad time?
Mosley, police station, PC Madden speaking.
Yes, it's Jean. Have you still got him?
Yeah, but I don't think he'll be much longer.
Good. Keep him. You've chosen an excellent time, Councillor.
Is he ready to go, then?
No. He's still being interviewed.
But Jean explained everything.
Not to me.
He might be being brutalised. I saw a documentary.
He's not even been arrested.
In that case, I demand that you release him.
That new jacket?
This? No, I've had it ages.
It's nice. Is that an ice cream Mars bar?
Lovely.
Okay.
Interview begins at 16:34 hours. So, why did you deliberately let down the tyres on that vehicle?
No comment.
So it was a random act of vandalism.
It was political. It was to hide the police negligence in the face of continued exploitation of that spot.
Very articulate. You write that down?
Yeah.
For the benefit of the tape, suspect has it written on his hand. For the benefit of the tape, suspect is now flicking the V's.
For the benefit of the tape, I have been a victim of police harassment at the hands of Sergeant Swithenback. And the only reason he goes down the lodge is because he fancies Jean.
Interview terminates at 16:35 hours.
He's jealous because she likes me more than him. She's always trying to snog me and all.
As you know, Jean, we announced our plans to sell Bramble Lodge 3 months ago. And I must admit, the response has taken us by surprise.
You've had a lot of objections.
On the contrary. We expected a lot of objections. We've received very few.
But I wrote several letters to people at every level within the council.
I should correct myself. We have received a lot of objections. But they were all from you.
Yes, on behalf of the residents. I speak for everybody here.
You do not speak for everybody.
Yes, I do.
You do not. That is why I am here. I am going to talk to the residents individually.
Talk to them? You won't mention the closure, will you?
Why not?
Because they don't like talking about it. They even act as if it's not really happening. It's called being in denial. Which is fine because the closure might not happen and then they won't be in denial after all, so don't mention it. Please.
I shall discuss whatever they wish to discuss.
Right. Well, let me introduce you to one or two of the residents.
I shall choose my own tour guide. Thank you. Go on, as if I'm not here.
He puts the taser to this guy's neck. Nothing. He only forgot to charge the battery.
You're joking.
I had to hit the bloke with my shoe, because it's the only thing we have.
Oh, they're as daft as each other, those two.
They've been in there a while now. I should check what's going on.
They'll be fine. Don't go bothering them.
I said don't.
You better rest me then, because I'm serious.
You don't belong in that place anyway. The people in wheelchairs.
All right, Paul.
So?
Of course, I could arrange it so you were entitled.
Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
5 minutes with me, mate, and you'd fit right in.
Is that a threat?
Sheldon, you coming home?
No, Paul, not until this joker does something about that car parking space.
Tough, it's not going to happen.
Right, well, I'll go straight back and slash the tyres on the next one, and it'll be all your fault because you set me free to re-offend.
He's got a point, sir.
Huh?
People do abuse that parking space.
When did we suddenly become traffic wardens? It's none of our business.
Well, I don't mind keeping an eye on it.
You have got more important things to do.
Fine, I'm going to go and slash some more tyres right now.
Fine, next time I will arrest you.
Good. You will hit the papers, you look all right, bastard.
Good, I am a bastard.
Sarge, there must be something we can do. We are community officers, and I know Jean would be grateful.
Bloody hell, Sarah. Wait there.
Look, yeah, he just gets overzealous sometimes, yeah? He's got your best interests at heart.
There! You want cars clamping, you clamp them.
What?
You heard. Go on, knock yourselves out.
Fine, I will.
Here, grab that.
Oh, Paul.
Blimey, they're heavier than they look on the bill, aren't they?
So, how long have you lived here? A couple of months, just whilst I'm at my own place. God, I'd hate to be stuck here permanently.
Really?
Oh, how are you two getting along then?
Very well. I'm hearing some interesting opinions on the future of Bramble Lodge.
Really? Yeah, well, Dorothy's not that representative. I mean, Dotty by name, Dotty by nature. Why don't you ask, Graham? Graham, you like it here, don't you?
It's not bad.
There we are. It's not bad means good.
The food is boring.
Yes, well, we try our best.
We can't get Channel 5.
Yeah, but those are little things, Graham. I mean, you'd miss the place if it wasn't here, wouldn't you?
We agreed to let the residents speak for themselves, Jean.
Right. Graham, do you love Bramble Lodge?
Yes.
There you have it. Next.
That wasn't me.
Anything else, Dorothy?
Hardly know where to start. You ask me, the old place should be knocked down.
Yes! I hope the V1.
Yes, it's like a rat in a trap, a lamb to the slaughter, a rabbit in the headlights.
All right, Wordsworth, just get the clamp fitted.
Right.
Come on, hurry up.
Give me a chance, I've never done this before.
I'm gonna get Sid. I wanted to see this.
And when he gets his own car, he can clamp himself for security.
So, in a nutshell, everybody loves living here and no one wants you to close the lodge.
That's not the impression I got.
Yes, it is.
As far as I can tell, none of them know about it.
What?
None of your residents know you're being closed down.
Oh. I've never heard anything so silly. You haven't told them, have you?
It isn't my place to tell them, Jean. It's yours. And if you don't do so immediately, you might find that you leave Bramble Lodge sometime before everyone else.
Paul! Paul, you really like living here, don't you?
What?
Tell the councillor how much you really love Bramble Lodge.
You're a councillor?
Yes.
Right. You're the ones who should be protecting that space.
I don't understand.
There's a disabled parking space out there that's constantly being abused.
Well, that won't be a problem for long.
Oh, well, it's a problem now.
Well, not just at this moment, because I'm parked there.
You?
I suffer with Ehlers-Danlos type 3.
Ooh!
And mild arthritis, so I do understand how frustrating it is when people abuse the disabled bays.
You've got a disabled badge?
Of course.
Right. If you'll excuse me, ladies.
My mother had a cat that died of arthritis. Quite painfully.
Shell, have you done it?
Oh, yes. Mission accomplished.
I think we might have made a terrible mistake.
Oh, no. Hang on. Look. It's showtime!
Say, Sarge, I'm surprised you handed over that wheel clamp.
Putting power in the hands of the community.
But they might use it on someone. And if it gets traced back here, you'll be in trouble.
Wake up, will you, Sarah? I didn't give them a real one.
Well, it looked real.
It's knackered, though. Lock's buggered. I'm hardly going to hand out one they can actually clamp people with.
Watch this, Paul. Watch this.
No
Nice one, Houdini.
Well, that wasn't supposed to happen.
No, it's good. We've had a lucky escape there. She's entitled.
I'm sick of people taking liberties. I'll show her who's entitled.
Oh, wait. Dale, stop! What are you doing?
Come on! How was I supposed to know it was legit?
There was a badge in the window.
They'll never let me stay now. Look, I packed all my stuff. I'm leaving.
Well, where will you go? Where will you sleep?
I can't tell you that. I'll be on the run.
Sheldon, I've stopped asking myself why you commit these violent criminal acts.
He didn't notice the disabled badge.
Well, you say that as if it explains his behaviour.
Look, I've gone, Jean, okay? Disappeared. Just forget you ever met me. I'm just...
There's no need to leave us, Sheldon.
There is. I'm a fugitive from the law.
No, you're not. I spoke to Sergeant Swithin back and he's not going to pursue the matter.
That's not like him.
Think about it, Shell. He supplied the missile. That makes him an accessory.
But what about her in the car?
Oh, forget about her. I persuaded her that the attacker was an obese adolescent. She's had it coming a long time, that one. Arthritis, my foot.
I mean, I can stay.
Of course you can stay. We don't throw people out on the street at Bramble Lodge. Never have, and we never will. Not as long as I draw breath.
What's all that about?
Who cares? You can stay.
I still say it was a worthy cause.
Worthy, yet futile. After you smashed up that councillor's car, she decided it wasn't a safe place to park.
So?
Bastard!
So it better be good, lads.
Read this.
How long have you known, Jean?
Known what?
That the councillor's selling off Bramble Lodge.
They can't do that. It's our home.
So what do?
We take action.
Just little warning shots.